My name is Father Ethan Southard. I'm the pastor here at St. John Eudes, and it's a delight to have you here tonight. We're so proud of our young people and Mrs. Martinez. We look forward to the show tonight, and it's my pleasure to introduce our principal, Mrs. Monica Lucariello. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. It's so wonderful to see all of you here and to welcome you to St. John Eudes School. This is our 2022 Christmas show, O Come, Let Us Adore Him. So the children and Mrs. Martinez and the teachers have been working so hard to prepare this performance for you as their gift to you for this holiday season. So welcome. I heard there's some alumni in the house, so welcome our alumni, all of our families and friends. Welcome. Thank you for being here tonight, and we will get this show started.
There's hope. When they heard the sound of the Lord God moving about in the garden, the man and his wife hid themselves from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. Then the Lord God called to the man and asked him,
"Where are you?"
He answered, Then the Lord God asked the woman.
"Why would you do such a thing?"
The woman answered.
Then
the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between
your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head, while you strike at his heel."
Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did in not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore." The angel Gabriel continued,
"Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies. All this because you obeyed my command."
See what I see. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever.
Thank you. But a shoot shall sprout from the stump of Jesse, and from his roots a bud shall blossom. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, a spirit of wisdom and of understanding, a spirit of counsel and of strength, a spirit of knowledge and of fear of the Lord. And his delight shall be the fear of the Lord. Then the angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God.
Behold, you shall conceive and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. Behold, you are the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to thee according to your will."
The angel gave
And Joseph, too, went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. When they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. The angel said to the shepherds, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news for all the people.
For a Savior has been born for you, and this will be a sign for
you.
You will
find him in a manger wrapped
in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of heavenly hosts, with the angel praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
Angels, we have heard on high.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying,
"Saw his star is rising, and have come to do him homage."
Then King Herod called on the magi to send them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem.
"Go and search for the child. When you find him, bring me word that I too may do new homage."
Thank you. There was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
He was in the beginning with God. All things came to be through Him, and without Him nothing came to be. What came to be through Him was light, and this light was the light of all human beings. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome.
Not by natural generation, nor by human choice, nor by a man's decision, but of God. And the Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us. And we saw His glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
Eighth grade, that was a beautiful way to end our show. If we can give them a round of applause again. Thank you all, boys and girls, for participating tonight. There was so much work that came into putting the show together. so I have some special thank yous to share with you. First and foremost, a giant thank you to Mrs. Martinez, our music teacher and choir director. Mrs. Martinez has dedicated so much time and love practicing music, songs, and lyrics with the whole school. She even taught our junior high to play the ukulele. So thank you, Mrs. Martinez. We thank Mr. Matt Park on the piano. Your gift of music and time for our students is invaluable, Mr. Park, and we thank you so much for that. Please make sure you picked up a program tonight. Those were designed by Mrs. Prospero in the front office, so we thank Mrs. Prospero for putting that together for us. Thank you to Mrs. Clarissa Martinez here in the front for dedicating her time to help film this performance for us tonight. Thank you. Thank you to our entire middle school staff for their help in navigating schedule changes and preparing the eighth grade for this Christmas performance. If you noticed, all of the eighth graders memorized their lines. We're so proud of them. And we had a last-minute substitution of two of the actors, which we didn't even know this morning. They did such an awesome job. So congratulations, eighth grade. And those middle school teachers we'd like to acknowledge are Ms. Devon, Ms. Bechet, Ms. Nemec, and a big thank you to Mrs. Vasquez for helping our eighth graders prepare as well. Thank you to all the teachers and staff here at SJE who also help prepare their students, and we're always willing to help whenever needed. We're so thankful for all of you. Thank you. And the festivities continue tomorrow night. We'd like to give you an invitation to the Night of Bethlehem. We'll start here at 5 p.m., so all are welcome. We look forward to continuing our Christmas celebration with you then. Friends and families, from all of us of St. John Eudes School, we wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. May God continue to bless all of you and keep you safe. Before I let you go for tonight, some dismissal news. So our fourth through eighth graders will go to Grill Hall. So just in a couple minutes, our fourth through eighth grade will go to Grill Hall, where parents and families, you can go and collect them there. Our TK through third grade will stay here in the church, and families can collect them right from here. So once again, fourth through eighth grade will go.